Welcome students, today we learn about class Polychaeta of phylum Annelida. So poly means many, chaeta means setae. So that's why the name Polychaeta. So these Polychaeta animals are mostly marine animals. So these are commonly known as Brazil worms. So these are free moving, burrowing or tubicolous. Burrowing or tubicolous, they make hole in the sand. They form a tube-like structure and they live, the burrow a tube and they live inside the tube. That's why these are known as tubicolous animals. So the head is distinct with the sense organs. A distinct civilization starts in Polychaeta. The head consists of sense organs like eyes, tentacles and the palps. So parapodia with many setae help in locomotion and respiration. So the trunk region, the body consists of parapodia. So these are useful for the locomotion and they contain, each parapodia contains numerous setae. That's why the name Polychaeta. So next, clitellum, which is a characteristic feature of annelids, is absent in polychaetes. Next, these animals are unisexual animals and gonoducts are absent. Gonoducts means the ducts which carry the germ cells are known as gonoducts, and the gonoducts here is absent, and the gametes are released into the coelom, and from the coelom they are liberated outside through the nephridiopores. Next, fertilization is external. So as the germ cells are liberated outside the body, fertilization occurs in marine water. That's why the fertilization is known as external fertilization. Fertilization which occur outside the body is known as external fertilization. Next, development is indirect development with the larval form. The larval form is known as a trochophore larva. So these are the some of the important characters of Polychaeta. So this question is also important for board examination for 4 marks. Examples for Polychaeta are Neris, which is commonly known as a sandworm, and Aphrodite, which is commonly known as a sea mouse. I think you understood. Happy studying.